energy up. I thought it was too much. He said, but I had to keep coming, even though I thought it was too much. And so I said to him, I said, look down this street. We were standing in the parking lot. And he looked, and I said, do you see all these churches? He said, yes. I said, what's the difference between them and us? I said, give me one difference. And he said, well, for starters, they have instruments, and we don't. I said, so we understand our market. He said, yes. I said, so thus, if God has told us to use our voices, why not do it to the best of our ability?
Yes.
I said, what I've never heard a person do is come into a congregation where folk have shown up saying and say, I miss the organ. What I've never heard someone do is come into a congregation where they were really praising the Lord with the fruit of their lips and from their heart with all sincerity and say, man, I really miss somebody beating the drum. What I've heard someone come in and say, man, I've never heard singing like this before. And I've heard them say, you know, this is the first time I've ever participated in a worship service. Normally, I sit and I listen, but here, I feel like I'm supposed to participate. And so whatever we do with our voices, if it's with our teaching, with our preaching, we serve a first-class God, and we give God first-class service. If this is what God has commanded us to do, why not do it to the very best of your ability? So when folk come, you say, look, we make no excuses. We don't say we're sorry for what we do. We say God has commanded this, and we're going to do it to the best of our ability until Jesus comes back and calls us home. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Now turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor.
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 Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
I don't know what you've come to do.
Sing praises, sing praises, sing praises.